You are listening to chartingwealth.com for Thursday, the 15th of February, 2018. We're going to relaunch our Bitcoin training, re-offer it again to you. If you have not taken it in the past and are interested, please go ahead, make sure you're a subscriber. And when you get your first email from us, simply reply to that Bitcoin, and we will send you the link to the training along with the chart that we developed for Bitcoin. It uses a true strength index, not our price percent oscillator, and we'll be happy to put you on that. We've received nothing but rave reviews for that training, and we'll make it available to all of our subscribers. Now, enough about Bitcoin. Let's jump into the markets. We see the S&P 500 up for the day 1.39%. Remember, we had a weekly vertical crossover going down after that big down week last week ending that's Friday the 9th of February. So far, we have a green up candle for the week. Our price percent oscillator still heading down. Again, it is an oscillator with all that strong down movement. The oscillation is still negative, and the derivative oscillator still is a long negative box down. And what does this mean? Well, it means we still have all of that energy and momentum weighing on the market. We do have a green, solid green up candle, has a wick on the bottom. Again, that's our Heiken Ashi candlesticks. Now, as we look a little closer, we see on the two-day chart still heading down, derivative oscillators losing downward momentum. Price percent oscillator is heading down, but not at the same steep, strong angle. It is not quite flat, but we see that the first two-day candle of the week representing price movement on Monday and Tuesday was a green closed box candle, is strong up. What we see with the latest is an open box green candle, even more upward momentum with a long wick on the top, short wick on the bottom. We're still negative on both the two-day and on the weekly charts, but we do see things perhaps reaching a bottom. Don't know that yet. What we would call it at this point is we have a pullback underway. In other words, we had things reach a bottom somewhere around on our Heiken Ashi candlesticks of about 258.69. We had a four-hour crossover in the afternoon on Tuesday. We had some up movement in the morning, stronger up movement in the afternoon for a total of 1.35%. We shall see. Will this be a long-lasting pullback, enough that we'll eventually pull the two-day chart over and then the weekly? We don't know that yet. What we are primed for is for things to rotate back over, moving down. Why? Because our rule is when we have a weekly vertical crossover going down, it serves us time and time and time again, telling us that indeed there is significant weakness in the market, and we wait for a potential pullback unless we have a jumping in point at 10:30 the following Monday morning after the weekly vertical crossover, which we did not, I repeat, we did not have, so we did not enter. We are simply waiting to see if indeed this pullback turns into truly a pullback, or if the market is just going to keep going back up again. And if it does, it'll pull the two-day chart over first and then the weekly. Hasn't done that yet. We'll continue to monitor and watch. Remember, we are not forecasters. We are trend followers. And currently, our two-day and our weekly trends are down. A lot of heavy energy pushing in that direction. Okay, that's where we are on the S&P 500. The Q's about the same, 1.87% for the day up. That's even more than the S&P 500. When we look at the price percent oscillator, not quite flat at this point. Derivative oscillator still very negative. Price percent oscillator going flatter. We have a green, solid green candle with a wick on the bottom. That's where we are at this point as far as the first 3 days of this latest 5-day candle. But again, we are still in the negative on the price percent oscillator, our master indicator. We go to the 2-day chart, the price percent oscillator has actually gone flat. Derivative oscillator starting to lose energy. This is the first day of the latest 2-day candle, green open box with a long wick on the top. So again, price movement still below the Well, we're just continuing to watch where that price movement is going. And in fact, when we drill a little bit deeper into the 4-hour chart, we will see that it had a 4-hour crossover in the afternoon on Tuesday, just like the S&P 500. And again, we've had third day of up movement. That is since Monday. And again, no jumping in point on a down move. We can call this right now, since both our 2-day and our weekly are down. This is technically a pullback for us based upon the weekly vertical crossover going down. And we shall see if it will rotate back over going down, crossing over like it did back on the 30th. If indeed we see a pattern like that, that would be our jumping in point at the close of that candle. So we'll just wait and see what we see. Remember, the charts lead us. We don't force the charts. You can't force the market. That's why we follow the market. That's why we trend follow. And it works over and over and over again when the patterns are correct, like they were on TLT, which is where we go next. Remember, we had a short position here. We had a weekly vertical crossover going down back on the 5th of January. Bonds really just sort of flattened out and started to roll over. Our jumping in point was that following Monday at around 10:30 or so. And what have we seen happen? We have seen we're now going into our 6th week of strong down movement. We were down 1.11% for the day. Price movement well below the 2-day and the weekly trend line. Derivative oscillator gaining downward momentum. Price percent oscillator is on about the same angle it has been over the last 2.5 weeks. So that looks beautiful for that downplay. If you don't understand what we're talking about, why would you buy something that is losing value? That's because we're taking a short position, either buying an option on TLT in our virtual trading account, or we are looking for a device that is an inverse fund. The problem with TLT, the inverse funds, is they tend to be less liquid than something like the Qs or the NASDAQ 100 or the S&P 500. That is where options are typically a better choice. But I do encourage you to listen to our training on inverse funds, how to make money when markets crash. We've gotten a lot of good feedback on that. You can find that both at the YouTube channel and at the website chartingwealth.com. What do we see going on? Well, we did have a green up candle for the two-day candle that ended on Tuesday the 13th. This latest, first day of the latest 2-day candle is a nice red down candle. We do see the derivative oscillator losing some downward momentum, but the price percent oscillator over the last day has ticked down at a downward angle. It was starting to go flat on us. That is a good sign. And as we look at the 4-hour chart, what do we see? You know, we talked about things bottoming out and our concerns about that with that crossover back on the morning of the 13th, Tuesday. And then what happened? Things turned around on Wednesday morning, heading down in the morning and then in the afternoon, but hasn't crossed over going down yet. So again, keep your eye on things, but price did move below that floor of somewhere around 118.20, which is nice. Okay, folks, that's where we are on TLT. Go back to our weekly chart and cover our last chart and look at gold up 1.71%. Remember, gold is still undergoing a weekly vertical crossover going up. That happened back on the 5th of January. However, things petered out on gold after it maxed somewhere at 129.52 on our Heiken Ashi candlesticks, then down over the next 2 weeks. And we see that the derivative oscillator is continuing to lose energy, but the price percent oscillator so far the week is ticking up. We really have right now a green spinning top, which means indecision as far as the weekly chart goes, tending up with a longer wick on top than on the bottom. But as we look at the 2-day chart, we can see that it did cross over going down back on the 7th. Now, it looks like the price percent oscillator may be headed up to crossing over. This is just the first day of the latest 2-day candle. If you'll remember, candle ended on Tuesday the 13th of February was a doji, meaning lots of indecision, tending up, and of course, it did go up the following day. Again, just the first day of the latest 2-day candle. That won't finish drawing until the close of business on Thursday the 15th. We're still red on the derivative oscillator, and the price percent oscillator is still in the negative also, but it appears to be moving up toward a crossing going up. And of course, as we delve a little deeper into the 4-hour chart, we had that crossover in the morning on Tuesday the 13th, and of course it blew it out on Wednesday morning and then Wednesday afternoon. Nice thing is, it looks like our 4-hour chart is starting to trend again, which means, you know, when it's doing that properly, it ends up being a total trading chart, as it was for us so much over the last year. It was absolutely beautiful time and time and time again. When you see a chart that looks like that, that makes clean moves that you can follow, occasionally it can get a little sloppy, but over and over and over again, the chart just led us in the right direction. And of course, when gold is trending, that 4-hour chart's beautiful. And it looks like over the course of the last 2 or 3 weeks, it has started trending again for us, and it will work until it stops working. That's the market for you, my friends. That's where things are. Again, if you're interested in the Bitcoin training, please make sure you're a subscriber. When you receive your first email from us, that's your daily market review every day, just simply respond back, Bitcoin. We'll make sure that you get not only the training, the video training itself, but you'll also get a link to the chart that we have developed for Bitcoin so that you can follow it and practice trade it more accurately. That's where we are, folks. Thanks so much for being with us. Remember, chartingwealth.com is where you go sign up for the daily market review. Absolutely free. Put in your name, your email address, and we'll have you on the list. You'll get all the trainings as they are available. God bless, my friends. All the best from the whole team here at Charting Wealth World Headquarters.